Hey, how you doing? My name is Emilio, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the best password manager that you can be using for your Mac. There's a whole bunch out there. There's paid ones, there's free ones, but which are the free ones that are the best for you to use? Hey, as always, this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Hey, also, if you like our videos, I would love it if you give us a thumbs up and also subscribe. Clicking on that subscription button lets us know that you want to see more content. Now, what we're going to be talking about is three solutions that I would recommend that you need to try if you're looking for a great password manager. I mean, ultimately, you need to have a good password manager. The last thing that you want to do is be writing your passwords down. The last thing that you want to do is to be putting all your passwords in your head and nowhere else. And the last thing that you want to be doing is using the same password over and over and over again. It's something that I've seen so many times where people use the same password across multiple services, or they just change one character. And it's pretty much the same across a lot of the things that they log into. The bad thing about this is if there is a data breach that happens to happen on one of the services that you are using, that password is now out. And that password could then be grabbed and then reused across other services. So never, ever, ever use the same password. So then you ask yourself, well, I can't remember all of these passwords. And of course, you're not meant to remember all of these passwords, especially you want to make sure that these passwords are long and complex, that they have numbers, uppercase, lowercase, they also have special characters. They're difficult to remember. And this is where a password manager comes in handy, because you can let the password manager manage all of your passwords, the username, the password, as well as the URL that you are using to access specific services. So what we'll cover is three password managers that I would recommend that are free. There are also a whole bunch of paid versions, but as we talk through each one of these three, we'll show you what the free version gives you and what it doesn't give you. Let's now jump onto our Mac and we'll show you these three. First one that we'll look at is NordPass. Now, you may already be familiar with NordVPN. They do a great VPN service, but they also do a great password management service. Now, it does come in free and also a paid subscription-based version. The free version comes with really, really great security features, allowing you to secure all of your passwords, ensuring they remain protected. Unauthorized access is removed. It is really, really good. Also has a really, really great user interface. Works on macOS. It works across your iOS devices, but also works across other operating systems. It also works across a lot of browser extensions. Now, I love the fact that you can just add it to your browser. I've done it here on Chrome, but you can do it with other browsers as well. We can automatically save the passwords as you're going into specific sites. The service also does give you some password generation features, allowing you to create and generate very strong and very complex passwords, reducing the risk of your weak passwords being compromised in breaches. Now, what you get with the free one, it is only limited to one user account, while the more premium ones give you access to a lot of additional features, allowing you to also detect weak and reuse passwords. Like if your passwords are weak, if they've been exposed in data breaches, that is what the premium version will actually give you. And you can also attach files to items. So I would say start off with the free one, because the free one is fantastic, and then you can upgrade to one of the premiums if you need to go down that path. Completely for free, you need to go check out NordPass. Another great one here is Bitwarden, completely for free as well. It is open source and gives you a lot of features for that free account. But as the same as the NordPass, you can also upgrade to premium and to family accounts. And you've also got a range of business accounts that are available to you. But the free version gives you unlimited devices, which is great. Again, available across a whole range of operating systems, including your Mac, gives you the passkey management. All of your core functionality is there in the free version. The browser extension is also there, allowing you to just save your passwords directly in your browsers and fill in those passwords as you're going from site to site, and gives you all the auto generation of passwords, the auto fill stuff, the encryption of storage for your login credentials, and also allows you to securely share passwords, which is really, really helpful. You wanna be able to share them from device or from user to user, you can do that with Bitwarden. Now with Bitwarden, you will actually get the health check of your password to let you you know if your passwords are strong and secure. Now, because Bitwarden is completely open source, it means that there is a huge community that is there to inspect, review, and contribute to the code base. If you want to jump up to some of the premium ones, you'll get things such as an integrated authenticator. If you want to authenticate against specific QR codes and passcodes, etc., that are online, you get file attachments, emergency access, and some further reporting features. And then we move on to Apple's new built-in password manager. Now, for a very, very long time, Apple had this thing called Keychain, which was built into the Apple macOS operating systems for a long time, for years and years and years. But in the new version of macOS Sequoia, Apple has actually introduced a passwords application that is built right into your Mac. You can also get yourself a browser extension for this one. But what this has done is if you've got an old version of macOS with Keychain and you've been using Keychain, this has replaced that, and all of those Keychain passwords are automatically added into the passwords app. Much like the other two solutions, it will also give you an ability to create and generate new, strong, complex passwords. This also gives you a great security feature where you can see exactly which passwords have been compromised, which passwords have been reused across lots of sites, and which passwords are actually not very, very strong. And the nice thing about this one is that because it is made by Apple, it has full integration with all of your Macs and all of your iOS devices. So if you've got members of your family, you want to be able to share passwords, you can create like a vault of multiple groups. You can also do that with the passwords app. Now, of course, these three are fantastic password managers for you to get started and start saving your passwords securely. You do want those advanced features, and that's where you go to the paid options. But hey, that's it for this video. I would love it if you let us know down below in the comments what you thought of this video. Give us a thumbs up, like this video if you did like it. And as always, click on that subscription button on the bell so that you don't miss out on anything. And we'll see you on the next video.